Weapons restrictions lifted.
Someone's carrying it around.
Thank you.
delivering cargo.
Oh, wow. Thank you. I was afraid I'd never see it again. Oh, thank God. It looks exactly like it always did. Oh, you don't know what this means to me. It was my father's idea to move all the way out here. He thought he could get to the bottom of the Death Stranding all by himself. And we were right behind him. But look where it got us. If you hadn't come along when you did, the camera would be gone, and all our hard work would have been lost before anyone had a chance to see it. We can't let that happen. The world needs to hear about this. Someone out there will know what it means. So, connect us up. We want to be a part of the UCA. I truly hope our work will help to make a difference. Thanks again. I hope we get to meet again before too long.
Sam, it's Hartman. That camera you recovered contains some fascinating footage. The data stored on it was automatically shared with us after you added the photographer's shelter to the network, along with her father's research materials. Anyway, my lab still doesn't have a high-speed chiral connection, but I was able to check one of the images against a database at HQ. Based on my preliminary calculations, and the photographic and documentary evidence in our archives, I would estimate the paintings to be in the region of 30,000 years old, if not older. The artists were likely Neanderthals or other precursors who were migrating across the continent. See the dolphin-like creatures there? At the time, the cave would have been situated even farther from the coast than it is now. So how could the artists possibly have encountered dolphins? Answer, they couldn't. It is my belief that they had a brush not with dolphins, but with beached things. And that would mean the Death Stranding is not the first phenomenon of its kind, that it has happened before. Since the birth of our planet, countless species have gone extinct, from bacteria to dinosaurs. Scientists refer to the largest known mass extinctions as the Big Five. But there have, of course, been many other extinction events, albeit on a smaller scale. What if the artists were trying to document one such event, that of their own extinction? It would be the first record in Earth's history of a Death Stranding. And it would also lend credence to my theories. The sooner you come and connect me to the network, the sooner we'll know. Just imagine the mysteries we'll be able to solve. I'll be waiting, Sam.
Wonderful news, Sam. BB-28's vitals are nearly within optimal operating parameters. Just before I called, it opened its eyes. It was looking all over, as if searching for someone. And then, our eyes met. For a moment, I think. I tell you, it was almost enough to make me want to keep the kid for myself. Anyway, I still need to run diagnostics and make adjustments as needed. However, the fluctuating local chiral levels could pose a problem. Think you can bring one more site into the network? Once you have, and once I have subsequently confirmed that baby is functioning reliably, I'll release it into your custody. This is the last step. I promise. Just one more site. That's all we should need. Good luck.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Sam, I see you received a mail from our Mountaineer friend. Seems he's got an order for you. Might be good to give it a look.
Let's get back to work.
Thank you. you to deliver a package to. She's a strange bird. It lives even higher up in the clouds than we do. And the research she's doing? Well, it's out there, and then some. And we're talking straight up occult stuff, though she wouldn't be very happy hearing me say so. And she claims she's delving into the mysteries of the cosmos. Anyway, I found this rock out in the mountains with a handprint on it. And when I mentioned it to her, she got all excited. I honestly don't know what kind of close encounter she thinks it signifies. But I was wondering if you could bring it to her for me. And joining the UCA has opened my eyes to a few things. Like how there are all these people out there trying to make sense of the Death Stranding in their own way. And sure, her ideas may sound like the ravings of a lunatic to me, but they clearly mean something to her. I'd like to help her out. With your assistance, that is. You'll find an official order on the terminal.
Sam, it's just like the one at South Knot City. A vortex loaded with so much chiralium that it's almost off the charts. Slowly but surely, it's creeping closer to us here in Mountain Knot. At least that's what I think, but I can't see it. Not with the naked eye. But the data doesn't lie. It's the same temporal phenomenon that you told me dropped you in a war zone.
I told you. But that wasn't.
The Cupid's limiter can handle most chiral spikes, but we didn't plan for another supercell.
Another supercell?
I told you it was the same as before.
Mama, is that you?
You got me, Sam. It's been a while. But not really. Mullingen, Machna, we're the same. One body, one mind, one being. There's no point in trying to draw a distinction. Not in this world. We're all connected. Remember that.
Order assigned. Thank you.
Address ID verified. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you.
I've been expecting you. The Mountaineer told me all about you. This handprint you brought me, or stencil, as I prefer to call it, is a vital clue. It hails from an era long before the dawn of human history. I'm going to date it and lay bare the cause of the Death Stranding. And when I do, all the secrets of the cosmos shall be revealed. Did you know this mountain used to be a pyramid in ancient times? It's true. You won't find a place closer to the beach than this. To the wellspring, a source of untold power. How else do you think that chiral network of yours works? But I digress. Show me the stencil. Thank you. It's in excellent condition. Connect me to the chiral network. Now I have everything I need to date the stencil. Once I have my results, I'll share them with you and your colleagues at Bridges. You've done a good thing, Sam. If you find anything else, be sure to bring it straight to me. I'll be waiting.
Sam, it worked. BB-28 is in excellent condition. No evidence of lingering attachments or homesickness either. Perhaps its memory was erased after all. All that remains is for you to hook it up and take it for a run. I was hoping to return it to you as soon as possible, but... I don't want to. I mean, I do. But it's a little more complicated than that.
What?
We've got a problem. You may have heard about the massive supercell heading right for Mountain Knot City. I left my facility to perform some additional tests on the BB in the field, and now I find myself unable to return. You know the cabin on the mountainside, northeast of Mountain Knot? Let's meet there.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Soldiers. The uniforms date back over a century. World War II era, I suspect. Did you see the man leading the soldiers?
No.
I think it's the guy you told us about.
The born and bred warrior asshole who's gunning for BB?
He must be our ticket home, right?
Don't ask me. This is only my second time. And without BB, he'll be hard to find.
Lucky for you, I've got BB here in tip-top shape, just waiting for you. Where should we meet?
Is there anything unusual or distinct near you?
I'm in the sewers. Hang on. I can see a tower through a hole. A square tower. Right above my position.
Gotcha. I'll find it and search for a sewer entrance. Can you sit tight for now?
Gladly. I won't move an inch.
Yeah, well, if I'm slow, you might have to.
What?
That warrior asshole. He wasn't after me. He was after Bibi.
Fuck me.
Right. If he's looking for anyone, it's you.
Oh, no. Hurry the hell up, Sam.
Keep it together. I'm on my way. And don't hook up Bibi either. He'll lead him straight to you.
Oh, boy.
Not that you would, since you hate them.
I just did because I was scared to death.
Disconnect. Now.
Already done.
Don't let him take BB.
How? If he shows up with his soldiers, what do you expect me to do? Fight back? If I have to choose between BB and myself, well...
You won't. I'm ending the call.
Sam. It's not easy being me. No wife, no children, no friends. And so I sought solace. Sought company in the dead. Over time, I made them a part of me. 70% of who I am today. But meeting you has opened my eyes. You're very special, Sam.
here.
Sam.
Lou.
The little one should be working again. Let me see. Oh, well then. Maybe this is a special beach for soldiers who died in battle.
Maybe we should get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I'm surprised. I thought you would have abandoned BB by now.
Discard precious hardware? Never. So, do you still share memories? I see.
Stay here. Seems like I got other memories to tend to. I'm taking him down. I should get us both out of here.
You know, Sam, I'm starting to understand why BB is so important to you.
Huh?
It's just a tool. Life and death are supposed to be irrelevant. But we've got attached to each other all the same, haven't we?
Kid's not just a tool. Name's Lou.
Lou, huh? That's a good name.
Open fire. Please.
Forward.
him up.
Reinforcements.
Yeah.
Ready, Frank?
Reinforcement.
Go, go, go.
Weapon free.
Give him out. Light him up. Up the pace.
Fire.
Open fire.
Reinforcements.
Thank you.
reinforcements.
Go, go!
Thank you.
It's all my fault. I should never have put you in that prison. Anyway.
How's little Lou doing?
No response.
Well, look at that. That child's taking a shine to me. You two were out cold, so I had you brought here. You were right. Whatever you did back there returned us to our own world. I put your cargo and gear in your private box. You slept for a whole day, you know. Slept like the dead. I'm already back in Capital Knot. Fragile's beach has been coming in handy. Sam, I owe you an apology. Lou was the name you were going to give your own baby if he'd had made it. I should have pieced it together sooner.
Don't know what you're talking about.
I found some records from 10 years ago. A death, sudden, in the middle of a town. Young woman in the prime of her life. Nobody knew until it was too late. A void out. Her husband, who was a member of Bridges, had dooms. He tried, but he couldn't get to her in time. The whole town was wiped off the map, leaving nothing but a big crater and him. because he was a repatriate. People wanted answers. Did the man hide his wife's body on purpose? The only survivor was the only suspect. He was easy to blame, and people did. And pretty soon, they were blaming Bridges too. The man felt responsible, so he left. And his wife, who died, her name was Lucy. She'd been pregnant, poor woman. They were going to name their son Lou.
Didn't happen.
But it did. President Strand told me. She talked about you all the time. He didn't have to cut all ties and walk away, she said.
You wanna shut the fuck up?
Calm down, Sam. Take a seat. I told you before about my body. 70% harvested from cadavers. Do you want to know the real reason why? Because the story you've heard is one I made up. The truth is, I'm Frankenstein's monster. Artificial, grown from pluripotent stem cells. And when that vital spark didn't manifest in all my organs, they replaced the defective ones with those of the dead. I never had a birthday. I'm a soulless meat puppet. No ka, a dead man. People born the traditional way have beaches. You have one. BB too. But I have no such connections. No mother. No afterlife. No beach. You see now why I'm so obsessed with it all? Why I joined Bridges? The battlefield. Now that was an awful beach. But strangely, I didn't hate it, because I knew you were coming for me. I've never felt that before. Connected to someone, anyone. You didn't have to cut all ties and walk away. The president was right about that much.
Wasn't anything to walk away from. It's not like I was ever welcome there.
Come on, even I was welcome. Oh, that. You were holding it. It's an old dog tag. U.S. issue. Wasn't easy prying it out of your hand. Clifford Unger, as you can see. I looked him up in our database. Found a match. He was U.S. Army Special Forces. Fought in Kosovo, Iraq, Afghanistan.
That's him.
Well, that's all I've managed to dig up so far. You must be caked in chiral matter from the battlefield. Time for a shower, I'd say. Oh, I won't be joining you this time. The Die Hardman issue is no longer a concern. I've seen to it that our conversations won't be recorded.
Philosophy and so forth. As a result, a beach can be anything.
and those anythings form a multiverse. However, if many people die at once, their beaches can become entangled, creating a strand field. This phenomenon is exacerbated in wartime by omnipresent feelings of resentment and despair. Beaches are more easily and frequently entangled. On such a beach, exits vanish and experiences cycle endlessly. Picture it like a record player. The needle skips, playing the same phrase again and again. They're fighting a battle that has no beginning or end. Round and round it goes. Now, the battlefield you visited was in Eastern Europe in World War II. Which is strange, given that the man you encountered, Clifford Unger, played no part in that conflict. I can't explain it, but if you can connect me to the chiral network, who knows what we might discover.
Still there, Sam? If so, I have a request. When you're ready, head upstairs to the delivery terminal.
Sam Porter Bridges.